Hey, what's up, happy gardeners? I'm the Hawaii gardener, and I'm here to tell you you can grow mostly anything in Hawaii regarding fruits and vegetables. Some we cannot because it's not that cold here, but I'll show you some of the things you can grow right in your backyard and you don't need that much space. I thought it would be cool to do an experiment. I'm going to see which out of the three fertilizers works the best, and I'm going to be using these Tommy Toe tomatoes. These are some seedlings I grew from seed. They're in their cells. As you can see, they're a bit leggy. Right now it's been very windy and cool, and right now it's kind of drizzling. So very cool temperatures for the spring. So what I mean by leggy, if you don't know, it's very thin and long. And that's because they're trying to reach for the sun, because there hasn't been much sun lately, but they'll be fine. We'll make do with them. If you don't know what the Tommy tomato is, it's a type of cherry tomato, a little larger though, almost golf ball size. And they're an indeterminate tomato, which means they keep producing until something kills them off. In the mainland, it would be frost or cold. But I think if you keep them healthy in Hawaii, they'll keep producing. So we're gonna put all three in the same type of fabric pots and try three different fertilizers and see which one is the best. So I'm going to put them in these 5-gallon fabric pots. You can get them off Amazon. I've seen them at Lowe's and Home Depot sometimes, but they're cheap, they're durable, they've got handles so you can move them around if you need to move them, and they're good for air pruning, which is kind of pruning the roots so they're not balled up altogether. So when you grow them in regular plastic pots, they tend to ball up and knot up. And in this fabric pot, it gives it oxygen, so it does not do that, which is healthier for the plants. And these are cheaper, and they actually last, even though they're fabric, for many years, so you can reuse them again. So the three different fertilizers I'm gonna use are the Miracle-Gro Shake and Feed, which is good for tomatoes, fruit, and vegetables, they claim. And it's got some micronutrients in there, kelp, earthworm casings, feather meal, and bone meal, which is good for tomatoes since we're doing that. Second one's gonna be a popular organic fertilizer. It's Dr. Earth's organic natural tomato, vegetable, and herb fertilizer. So we'll see how that goes against the Miracle-Gro, which is not organic. So the next one we got is the Alaska fish fertilizer. It's a fish emulsion. It's organic as well for those who want to go organic. It's got a 5-1-1 ratio. So that's 5 nitrogen, 1 for phosphate, and 1 for potassium. Those are the NPK, what you need to look at when you're looking at a fertilizer and what you need. So let's pot these up and see how it goes. All right, so we got our first pot, and we're gonna do each pot the same, so I'm not gonna repeat it. If you need to go over it again, you can just rewind so it's not too boring. But I'm gonna be using some good potting soil, and you're just gonna fill up your pot. If you can't find the fabric pots, you can use a regular pot, that's fine. Halfway with the potting mix. And once you're halfway with it, I like to put in some bone meal and some blood meal. And so the bone meal has good phosphate and calcium. And it's good for the plants. I put about 2 little pinches of it right in there. I'm gonna give each pot this so they can have their fair share of for a good start. Next is gonna be blood meal. You can find both at any big box store or your local hardware store. I got these at Lowe's. I don't really see it at Home Depot in Hawaii, but you can find it at City Mill too. So we're gonna give it the same thing, maybe 2 pinchfuls. And this is high in nitrogen. So it's already a good starter fertilizer to get these seedlings going well. Mixing it in thoroughly into the soil. Next, I'm going to put some worm castings in. This gives some good micronutrients to your plants. It's basically from earthworms. Just one big handful and stir that in as well. And then I'm going to fill the rest of the fabric pot with the potting soil till it's up to the top. All right, so I filled the pot up almost full. And then you're just gonna take your two fingers or three fingers and just dig maybe 5 to 4 inches deep for your seedling. And I'm gonna put one more little sprinkle of bone meal and one more little sprinkle of blood meal. Kind of mix that together so the roots aren't gonna just lie right on that. All right, I got the seedling out and we're gonna put it in that 4 to 5 inch hole that we dug. And you're gonna put the soil into the hole and press down. Get all the air pockets out and make sure it's secure. And you can put the dirt a little bit higher up since it's kind of leggy and tall. All those little spiky little fuzzy things you see on the stem, those are actually baby tomato roots. So if you cover it up, it's going to make more roots. So it'll be fine. And I'm going to continue on with the next two. If you're wondering where I got these Tomato tomato seeds, I got them from Baker's Creek Seeds. They got an online catalog. It's totally seed porn. You're going to want to buy everything off their catalog. They've got great things and unique items. And the shipping's free. So if you're in Hawaii, that's a great thing. And it comes to our house pretty fast. So this is what the Tommy tomato looks like. And of course, I'm not sponsored. I'm just telling you the things I buy. All right, it's starting to rain. So this is the last one. And after you plant your seedlings, just give it a good watering. Try not to get the water on the leaves because that causes many diseases for plants. And I'd like to also mention, when you start transplanting your seedlings like this into a bigger pot or container, be sure to do it in the evening or right in the morning, early morning, where it's not too hot, because that will stress out the plant and this will give it a better chance to flourish when it's kind of cool and the sun isn't so strong. All right, all of a sudden it started to rain, but real quick, I've got all of the pots here outside where it's gonna get some good sun. This one's gonna have the Miracle-Gro. This one's gonna have the Fish Emulsion. And this one's gonna have the Dr. Earth fertilizer that's organic. And we'll come back in a couple of weeks and update you on their progress. And as they get bigger, I'll put some stakes in the ground. This tomato will have some Miracle-Gro shake and feed for tomatoes. It calls for about a tablespoon and a half. So we'll sprinkle it around. It's really windy, sorry. And water her in as well. And this is our last plant. This is with the Fish Emulsion, which I'm using the Alaska Fish Fertilizer brand. And here is, this one's a liquid, so you put 2 tablespoons per gallon of water, so it's an old gallon milk jug. It pretty much looks a little brown and it stinks. But we'll fertilize and water this. This one's gentle, so you can water the leaves, it won't burn anything. And we'll come back in a couple weeks and see how these all grew. All right, it's been 2 weeks for these Tomato tomatoes. So if you remember, this was the Dr. Earth Organic. This one was the Fish Emulsion. And this one is the Miracle-Gro. So I did put some Miracle-Gro in here, maybe a week after it got settled in. I put some Fish Emulsion in here. And we're following the directions, so I don't know if it's fair. But the Fish Emulsion, you can use once a week. Miracle-Gro says apply every 3 months because it is granular and melts as you water. And the Dr. Earth also says to apply every 3 months. As you can see, Miracle-Gro is pretty tall and healthy looking. But it's still thin over here. You can see with the Fish Emulsion, it's probably the tallest out of all three. Maybe that one's tall as well, but you see how healthy and thick the main stem is compared to that one. This one's not doing too well. I mean, it's healthy, but compared to the other two,
also thin but short. But we'll see what it produces when it starts to flower, and we'll check in a couple weeks later again. All right, we're out here a few weeks later, and everybody's doing well. And if you don't remember, this is the Miracle-Gro Tomato Tomato. This is the fish fertilizer, and this is the Dr. Earth's organic tomato and vegetable fertilizer. This one wasn't doing too well at first, but if you can see now, it's doing pretty well. It's got a very thick stem, which is good, and it's got more foliage than it did before, growing a nice top. Good leaves. And the last time, these two were doing much better than the Dr. Earth's, but now the Dr. Earth's seems to be doing well. This one I don't think is fair, but I'm following the directions. This one says every 3 months for the Miracle-Gro, so you apply it once every 3 months and you don't do anything after that. Same as the Dr. Earth's. You apply it, mix it in the soil before you plant your seedling, and it's every 3 months. This one, however, fish fertilizer, you can apply weekly. And so that's what we've been doing, because I've been following the directions on it. And it's just one little watering every week. I've been lazy. Sometimes I don't do it every week, maybe every 2 weeks. So kind of giving them a little fair advantage. But even though I haven't been doing it every week, the first one to have tomato flowers is the fish fertilizer one. So the Alaska fish fertilizer is the fertilizer that got the Tomato tomatoes their first flowers out of all of them, because this does not have any flowers yet, but soon they will, as well as this. Even though this is pretty strong, there are no flowers on here yet. But usually when you see little tops like this, the flowers will eventually come out. But so far, in the running is the fish fertilizer. Come back in a couple weeks and see how they're doing. All right, so another update. You can see the Tommy tomato plants have really grown well. That's the Dr. Earth's. The middle is the fish emulsion, and that is the Miracle-Gro. The one that had the first flowers was the fish emulsion. We thought that was growing actually the best, but the Dr. Earth's all of a sudden kind of just sprang out of nowhere, and you can see how thick the stem is and how strong it is compared to the Miracle-Gro one here. That's a little thinner, and it's just a full bush of healthy leaves. And this was the second one to get a batch of flowers, so we got that, and a bunch of new ones coming out here and right here. But this one had the first flowers, but this is all that popped up, and some over here, and you can see some of the tomatoes are forming. This one was the last one, the Miracle-Gro, to have flowers pop up, and that's all that popped up so far, just this bunch of flowers right here. And I see a little bit up top here of some new buds forming. So we'll come back and see how the tomatoes come out, probably in a couple of weeks. So it's been since April 5th. That's when I filmed myself planting the seedlings of the Tomato tomato. It is May 26th, and these are the results. I wish I could wait a little longer, but we're going to go on vacation soon, and I don't think they'll be ripe by then, but they should be fine while we're on vacation, I hope. But this is the results. This is the Miracle-Gro. They're all kind of about the same height. This one has a bunch of flowers here, a little bit of tomatoes here, and a cluster there. Strong stem, but not as thick as the others. This one was the fish fertilizer that I did weekly. I followed the directions on all the bottles, so the Miracle-Gro was to put it in every 3 months, so I have not refilled it. I put in the amount that they asked for and left it and let it be and watered it the same as all the others.
the fish fertilizer is weekly, and you've got the cluster of tomatoes there, a cluster here with some flowers here, and some flowers there that will be tomatoes eventually. Also some flowers here and a little tomato sprouting out. This one is the Dr. Earth's tomato and vegetable fertilizer. This one didn't do too well compared to the others in the beginning, but we've got a cluster here, some flowers here, some flowers here, a cluster here. And I don't know about you, but I think the Dr. Earth's did the best. It's growing well. It's kind of has more foliage, more tomatoes and flowers. I would say second place would be the fish fertilizer. Not as big in terms of foliage, but it's got more tomatoes and flowers than the Miracle-Gro. The Miracle-Gro has tomatoes as well, but if you're going to compare all three, I think the Dr. Earth's did the best. So you can make your determination based on your own preference of the brand you want, but this is the experiment I did. And I think either way it's a win-win. I get tomatoes all around, but I think the Dr. Earth's kind of surprised me. It's organic, it's vegan. I'm not a vegan, but you know, other people have different beliefs and also garden, and I think it did the best. So hopefully you found this experiment informative, and hopefully it can help you choose what fertilizer to pick. And remember, the Miracle-Gro isn't the regular blue water-soluble Miracle-Gro. It was the tomato and vegetable granules that slowly release in the soil. So it was a specific fertilizer for tomatoes. Pick what you want. I think in terms of value, the Dr. Earth's was a pretty big bag for a pretty good price. I got it at Home Depot. The fish fertilizer also I got at the hardware store, and it was pretty affordable as well. The Miracle-Gro I got from Amazon. Due to the fertilizer shortage, they didn't really have that specific type of Miracle-Gro at Home Depot or Lowe's at the time. And it wasn't expensive. All of them were pretty reasonable in price, but I think the most for your value is Dr. Earth's. So if you found this informative, please press the like button. If you're new, consider subscribing to my channel, and I will see you again.